Hey, Jimmy.
Howard.
So, have you thought any more about the job?
The job? Yeah. No, I'm still giving it some thought.
Giving it some thought?
Yeah.
You know what? Don't bother. It seems I've upset you, so offer's off the table.
You upset me? How'd you upset me?
You tell me.
This is getting a little weird, Howard.
You want to know what's weird? It's weird to offer a job to a man and in return have bowling balls thrown at your car. And prostitutes sent to your business lunch. That's weird.
Are you listening to yourself? I don't know what you're into these days, Howard, but prostitutes and bowling balls, you sound unhinged.
Jimmy, I'm sorry you're in pain.
You're sorry. You kill my brother, and you say you're sorry. Let me tell you something. The job offer, it didn't upset me. It amused me. Big job at the illustrious HHM. Chance to play at the palace. Little old me. You have no idea what's going on. You're a teensy tiny man in a teensy weensy little bubble.
No, Jimmy.
Oh, don't you fucking old Jimmy me. You look down on me, you pity me. Walk away. That's right, Howard. You know why I didn't take the job? Because it's too small. I don't care about it. It's nothing to me. It's a bacterium. I travel in worlds you can't even imagine. You can't conceive of what I'm capable of. I'm so far beyond you. I'm like a god in human clothing. Lightning bolts shoot from my fingertips.
Talk.
I had a dream last night while I was laying on my bed, and the whole world was standing still, and the moon was turning red. I saw a sign in the sky. I have come to set you free.
I know he's not perfect. And I know he cuts corners. But you're the one who made him this way. Sorry.
Just what?
You're the kind of lawyer guilty people hire.
What the hell is that?
I know you. I know what you were, what you are. People don't change. You're slipping Jimmy.
Give it to me, Chandler. I want it all.
Now, if this starts to leak, you're going to get the worst infection of your life. It's going to hurt like hell, and then you're going to die.
More.
It's all good, man.
They called her Fist Snatch, and they just walked.
Oh, fire! My wrist on, coming down. On my head, I saw fire. My wrist on, coming down. On my head, I looked around. I saw eyes. I heard a voice say, come to me. I feel her rumbling beneath my feet. And the whole world was shaking free.
Replace the carburetor. She's running like a racehorse, man.
It's a fine vehicle. It's a thing of beauty.
Yeah? What do you drive?
An Esteem.
A what?
A Suzuki Esteem. It's an import.
Huh. So?
Yeah, so it went just like you wanted. Assuming the dead drops are a real thing, feds are gonna be on them.
The feds?
Yeah. DEA. There's a matched pair of them, and they're into this with a vengeance. I mean, think feeding time in the lion cage. And, they're gunning for arrests.
Okay.
Oh, and your guy is now a confidential informant.
What do you mean, like a rat?
No, he's not a rat, no. I mean, well, if he's a rat, he's your rat, so. Put it this way, you now have a hotline to the DEA. And not just now, anytime. So that's a good thing, right? But the deal is, at some point, you might hear that Domingo is a snitch. You gotta know, he's not.
And what do you care?
Well, all due respect, you're paying me, but he's my client. I'd like to keep him alive.
Let's do it. What are they doing?
And one more thing. You're going to have to find a different attorney for future endeavors because my schedule is just very, very tight.
You'll make time.
Come on.